Remember when Democrats thought that George W. Bush was the worst president ever? Little did they know. In an interview that was streamed in mid-March with the Texas Tribune's Evan Smith, one thing was very clear about George W. Bush. He is fundamentally at odds with the current version of the Republican Party on almost every front. Let's go through them. On whether the 2020 election was stolen, as former President Donald Trump and many of his allies in Congress continue to insist without evidence, George Bush had a one-word answer: no. On Trump's takeover of the Republican Party, Bush was dismissive.
History in the United States has shown these populist movements begin to fritter over time. And so I'm optimistic about democracy.
On immigration, Bush rejected the hardline approach adopted by Trump to weaponize the issue during his 2016 campaign, Build the Wall, and during his time in the White House. Here's Bush, quote, "There needs to be an overhaul, which means that we need to get politics out of the system and get sober-minded people focusing on A, what's best for our economy, and B, what's best for our country," end quote. Then there was this on President Joe Biden, who Trump and some Republicans have insisted is in the early stages of a socialist takeover of our government. Here's Bush, quote, "He's off to a good start, it looks like," end quote. And then on the U.S. Capitol riot of January 6th, which many Republican elected officials have sought to downplay in its aftermath, Bush said this in a statement, quote, "The violent assault on the Capitol and disruption of a constitutionally mandated meeting of Congress was undertaken by people whose passions have been inflamed by falsehoods and false hopes," end quote. The contrast, as you can see, on nearly every issue of importance to the country is striking and stunning, and it speaks to how radically the Republican Party and what it allegedly stands for has been transformed by Trump's rise and continued death grip on the GOP. What's remarkable here is that Bush wasn't the head of the Republican Party all that long ago. We're not talking about someone who led the GOP in the 1970s or 1980s, like, say, Gerald Ford. Bush was president in the 2000s and was the last Republican elected president before Trump won in 2016. Less than a decade separates Bush's presidency from Trump's. And yet, in terms of how differently the two men conceive of the Republican Party, it feels more like 100 years. Remember that Bush ran as a self-proclaimed compassionate conservative. He repeatedly pushed for comprehensive immigration reform that even included an early version of a path to citizenship for those in the United States illegally. And perhaps most importantly, Bush was relentlessly focused on decency and civility in politics and life. As Bush himself put it in a 2018 conversation he had at the eponymously named George W. Bush Institute, quote, "I'm not sure that respect and civility are a political philosophy so much as they are an understanding of the importance of decency in society, whether in the political arena or how you treat your neighbor. There's no question we need respect and civility," end quote. Now contrast that with Trump's repeated assertions that his political opponents were, among other things, evil. One example of many, acquitted by the Senate over impeachment charges related to his handling of the USS relationship with Ukraine, Trump used the form of the National Prayer Breakfast to blast the, quote, "dishonest and corrupt people," end quote, who had pushed for his impeachment. He also questioned whether House Speaker Nancy Pelosi actually prayed for him.
"Nor do I like people who say, I pray for you, when they know that that's not so."
Trump, in fact, expressly positioned himself as a rejection of the establishment politics that he said the Bushes represented. Quote, "We need another Bush in office about as much as we need Obama to have a third term," Trump tweeted way back in 2013. And during the 2016 campaign, he would regularly mock Jeb Bush, the younger brother of George W., and the perceived frontrunner for the GOP nomination, at least at the start of the race, as an out-of-touch plutocrat with the current views of the Republican base. The Bushes responded in kind. The late Barbara Bush, the mother of George W. Bush and Jeb Bush, said this in 2016 of Trump, quote, "He doesn't give many answers to how he would solve problems. He sort of makes faces and says insulting things," end quote. Neither George W. Bush nor his wife Laura voted for Trump in 2016. They both chose the none of the above option, their spokesman told Politico. Bush didn't make public who he voted for in 2020, but in the days immediately after the election, even as Trump was continuing to contest the results, Bush very publicly congratulated Biden for his victory. Quote, "Though we have political differences, I know Joe Biden to be a good man who has won his opportunity to lead and unify our country," said Bush, adding, quote, "The president-elect reiterated that while he ran as a Democrat, he will govern for all Americans. I offered him the same thing I offered Presidents Trump and Obama, my prayers for his success and my pledge to help in any way I can," end quote. Bush's latest comments about the state of the country come in the wake of a series of retirement announcements by Republican senators, all of whom closely identified with Bush's preferred interpretation of what it means to be a Republican. The decisions by Senator Roy Blunt of Missouri, Rob Portman of Ohio, Pat Toomey of Pennsylvania, Richard Burr of North Carolina, and even Richard Shelby of Alabama, that's five, to step away from politics suggests that the rise of Trumpism and the resultant decline in Bushism has made the GOP a place they no longer feel entirely comfortable in. Polling, however, suggests that view is in the minority within the GOP. Trump remains the most popular figure among Republican-based voters, and the vast majority of party-elected officials have avoided any direct criticism out of fear of drawing his ire. Bush, who is constitutionally barred from serving as president again, is less constrained about calling it how he sees it. And that is The Point. We make new Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.